We're finding more and more mothers with children that are now coming to us at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And I want you to meet my special guest. Tell us your name.
Shannon.
And who's that you're holding?
Carson.
And that's your daughter?
Ivory.
How did you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center?
I started out in the Alive program through escaping domestic abuse.
Yes.
And they told me about you guys.
And so you came here.
And I called you guys, and I came here.
And now you're staying at one of our safe houses, aren't you?
Yes.
How do you hope to put your life back together at this time?
A plan. Build it one day at a time. Try to get back on our feet.
I can only imagine how hard it is to be a mother, particularly with an active 1.5-year-old. And then your daughter, we need to get her in school. It's difficult, isn't it?
It is.
Let's hear from you, Ivory. What do you think? Is it hard sometimes? But you're sticking with it and helping Mama all you can? Yes, I want you to please keep this family in your prayers, but they're not alone. We have so many others that are coming at this time, and that's why we need your ongoing prayers. I believe you're trying to get a job, and you're going to try to save some money and get into your own place and start all over.
Yep.
Wow. And this little guy can be quite active at times, can't he?
Too many.
What are things God's teaching you while you're here?
Patience.
A lot of patience?
Patience.
How important is it that you trust him and ask for his help every day?
Very important.
Yes, make no apologies. A Christian community, trying to help people with the physical, mental, spiritual. I ask you to pray for our safe house mothers, as we refer to them as, the leaders of the safe house. They open their hearts up, they open their homes up, they adopt the different individuals. And I just thank God for all of you that are praying for us at this particular time and just letting the light and love of Christ work in you. And through for 50 years, New Life Evangelistic Center has been on the front lines, reaching out among the hurting and the homeless. And we just can't do it without all of you. So I'm asking you to please pray for us at this very critical moment.
I was praying and praying every day for me and my children to have a place to go. And then I found this place, and I was thankful to have this place and have a roof over our head.
Were you really worried you'd be sleeping outside?
Yeah, I was. I was scared. Two children and a 9-year-old and a baby. I was really scared.
Yes.
And then aftermath of like someone finding out that I'm sleeping on the streets, I could have lost my children.
Are you meaning that they could have been taken from you?
Yeah.
And that was a real fear in your
life.
That
was a fear that I was scared of.
I thank God for each one of you. Without you faithful partners, we could just not be there for them. And the only way we can is because of our faithful partners. At New Life Evangelistic Center, we don't receive city, state, or federal dollars. And we have mamas coming, babies coming, people needing help. And I'm asking all of you to please continue to keep us in your prayers here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Lots of people at this time. I think you told me you were calling the other shelters, and as you were asking for help, what were they telling you?
They had no space. All the flood victims are in the shelters right now. There's no space.
At all?
None.
Well, you, each one of you, supporters, each one of you that are praying for us at New Life Evangelistic Center, are an answer to the prayers. And I ask you to please keep this dear sister and her children in your prayers. She's now trying to find employment and daycare for the little one. And the daughter's going back to school. She's trying to really put her life back together. We're trying to work with her. If you'd like to volunteer, I encourage you to call us at the New Life Evangelistic Center at 314-421-3020. And again, I'd love for you to be praying for us here and help sponsor this family by sending your gift to New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. And without this place, you don't know where you'd be going right now at this time?
No.
Well, we need everybody praying and sharing, don't we? Yes, that means every one of you. You're so urgently needed at this very critical moment.
One by one, save a child from his pain. wipe away the shame. Smile by smile, we can set their spirits free. Choice we have to make, soul to soul, be the hope that lights their way, and we can be the hope for the children. We can make a
thank God for each one of you that are providing hope for the children. For 50 years, New Life Evangelistic Center has been on the front lines directly helping children. And now a big part of our outreach is to providing a place for mothers and their babies and hurting people at this time. And I want you to meet my new guest. Tell us your name.
My name is Alyssa.
And you have there Noah?
Yes.
Now, how important is for you that you have a place at the New Life Evangelistic Center at this time in the safe houses?
Very important, actually. It's given me the opportunity to be able to have a stable place, not worrying about one place, going from one place to another, or money for a room at a motel and packing up our things and moving from room to room whenever was necessary.
Is that what life was like before you came to us?
Yes, for about the last 2-3 months.
A lot of money spent at hotels?
Lots of money. When my aunt and I did the math, it was a little over $2,000 a month just in motels.
People don't realize how hard it is and how many people right now are trying to survive in these hotels that are just sucking up their money, right?
Exactly. And not only that, but so many of the motels are booked up right now, you know, especially with the summer, people coming in and visiting. But not only that, so many people are living out of the motels right now that it's really hard to find a room, and the motels are having to... Yeah, hotels are having to raise their rates because of the demand.
So they're raising their rates, and you try to call shelters, they're all full because of the flooding that took place.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people are hurting right now, and we're seeing more and more women and children. And Noah, he's about, what, 4 months old?
Yes, yeah.
And he's just growing and growing, isn't he?
He is. It's about every 6 weeks or so we're going up a clothes size, it seems like.
Yeah, so again, you had to take all your stuff, go from place to place, spend over $2,000, so any dollars you'd make was going straight to the hotels.
Yes, yeah, there was hardly any money left over at the end of the day sometimes. Sometimes it was hard to get a meal for myself. Thankfully, you know, there's resources out there to get Noah the, you know, the formula that he needed. However, for myself, it was very hard.
Now she has an opportunity to save money, to break the cycle of homelessness, to get in her own place, all because of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. People being set free. It's so exciting. And New Life continues to work with the women, the children that come to it, sometimes for years, like we've had that opportunity with Audrey. And this past week, I had an opportunity to sit down with Audrey, her children. I want to share a little bit of that interview with you, just to show you the impact that you're having among the children, the mothers here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. What a big difference for good you're making. And I just praise God for each one of you that are making this possible by sharing those much-needed gifts with the New Life Evangelistic Center. At P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org and be a part of the blessing that God is doing at this hour in the lives of so many hurting and homeless women and children. I'm with Audrey. And Audrey, when you first came, wow, you didn't have any home at all, did you?
No, I did not.
Tell us about your situation.
My house, the apartment that we was living in had caught fire, and then FEMA or Red Cross, they wasn't able to help, so we were homeless. I had three children and myself, and also I was pregnant, didn't know. So I had to have my two youngest children go with their father, and then it was just me and my oldest son, and we wung it out.
And since we've been working with you, Journey came along too, didn't she?
Yes.
In fact, she was kind of surprised, wasn't she?
Yes, she was.
She had just arrived at our place, and she'd just been with us a short period of time, and they had some kind of indigestion, went to the hospital.
And popped out a baby.
Wow, Journey's a miracle. Yeah. That sounds really hard, but I can testify to it. It's a fact. And then these two have been with us for quite a while also, and it's just such a blessing to see how God has been working. What would happen to you if New Life hadn't been there for you?
I think I probably would have ended up getting my kids taken away. I just probably would have been out on the street because we had nowhere to go. We didn't have no kind of help. I was working, but it wasn't helping at all.
And she was in our safe house for a couple of years almost, I think, and then we went from that to transitional housing where she's been. So we've continued to work with Audrey, and hey, we didn't even introduce these two. Tell us who they are.
That's Justice, and she's five.
She's five, okay. And this one?
That's Michael, and he's seven.
That's her brother.
Mm-hmm.
They almost look like twins.
Mm-hmm.
So again, just some of the children here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and the way we're able to help them is because of all of you that are praying for us here at New Life and just letting the light and love of Jesus work in you and through you. What a blessing you are. And again, they're making a big difference, people are, as they support to work a New Life Evangelistic Center. You have a job now?
Yep, working at St. Luke's Theory Place. Been there for a year and 7 months now.
And even with that, though, it's hard when you're trying to self-raise four children, isn't it? What's the hardest thing about being a single mother with four children?
Paying bills, making sure that the kids eat, because really I don't get any food stamps because they say I make too much money. But with making too much money, I still have to pay my bills. I still have to make sure that the kids have a roof over their head, clothes, and all that necessity. So it's hard. It's tough. I'm trying to make it.
Well, without New Life's assistance and the transitional housing and working with you like this and establishing a rate you could afford, it'd be even harder.
Yeah, it will. It would be even harder because they wouldn't have the necessary things that they need to have, because I will have to make sure that my bills are taken care of for us to actually have a roof over our head.
And folks, you all are just such a blessing at this time. You're getting ready to go to school?
Yes.
What grade are you going to be in?
Second.
You're going to be in second grade. You going to go on sometime?
Uh-uh.
Oh, not yet, but soon, right?
She's going to kindergarten.
Oh, is she? Well, we thank God for all of you that are making it possible for us to be able to help the children and just letting the light and love of Jesus shine in you and through you. What a blessing you are in the lives of so many at this particular time. Jesus said, let the little children come to me, forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. Here's how it was. She came and she was with us a couple of years. New Life provided all the resources for her. And then to do an assessment of her income, she only be able to share a small
small part of that towards actually our rental facility that we got her into, and we're subsidizing that for this family because we don't want to see the mother and the children out on the streets. And that's why your prayers and support for the work of New Life Evangelistic Center are so important at this time. And we ask you to send that gift to New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at NLECSDL.org.
I'm with Alyssa at this particular time. And Alyssa, what is the hardest thing about being a homeless mother? You had to flee a domestic violence situation, I believe, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of women encountering this at this particular time. And a lot of women that find themselves homeless for a wide variety of reasons. But tell us a little bit, what's the hardest thing about it?
The hardest part, like I was saying, not only transitioning from place to place and sometimes having to leave things behind, was really giving Noah a place where he was able to hit his milestones, learning to roll over, sit up, crawl. You know, we weren't really in environments where it was safe to be teaching him those things. And now having that stable home, you know, we have time to work on those things together that, you know, he should be reaching at this time.
The safe houses that New Life Evangelistic Center has involves women. Actually, we have a house mother, and she's usually there with anywhere from 3 to 5 women, and they have an opportunity to actually create a home at that situation while you go out and look for work, or in your case, you do have a job.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and it's creating a balance, and it's really giving me a lot of peace, and I'm getting on a routine of waking up early in the morning and getting my errands done, and going to work, coming back, and doing chores, keeping my room together, and just having my little organization in the room gives me such a feeling of relief. It's really wonderful.
And not only is it the mothers with the children that are coming to us. Yesterday, we had a woman, 62 years old. She was sleeping under a porch before she came to the New Life Evangelistic Center. So each one has an individual story. Each one of them has a crisis situation. And yet, during this time, New Life Evangelistic Center is just facing some really tremendous financial needs. It seemed like people goes on the vacation, they forget about, and they go on vacation when they're giving, and they forget about the needs continue to grow, the utility bills for all these different houses, the upkeep for all the different houses. Well, it just requires a miracle. And I thank God for those of you letting the love of God flow through you, because daily, it's a miracle that we can just continue to keep operating. And this has been over 50 years now. Yes, New Life Evangelistic Center for over 50 years has been reaching out through the love of Jesus among the fatherless and the widowed, the hurting, working to be there when people are hurting. What a blessing you are in the lives of individuals. How did you find out about New Life Evangelistic Center Safe Houses?
I was praying one night.
Tell me about it.
Noah had ended up in the hospital with our moving around. He was with a babysitter that wasn't safe. He was injured. So we were in the hospital at the time, and DFS had gotten involved. And I prayed that I would find somewhere safe to go, and that DFS would see that, you know, I was making an effort to try to make a better situation for us. And the next morning, I was looking for women's shelters, and this was the first place I called, and they got me in right away for an interview, and I've been very thankful ever since, because it's definitely, you know, given us what I needed at that time, and also realizing that I definitely need to strengthen my relationship with God, because I asked and I received.
We're a holistic program, not only the physical, mental, but the spiritual. And you've been a part of the spiritual outreach and the Bible studies with the women,
mm-hmm.
the prayer, and the women you live with all love the Lord. So it's helping you to grow and get back right with God, isn't it?
It definitely is. It's opened my eyes a lot. I've definitely been thanking him every night before I go to bed. I've asked him to give me the scriptures that he wants me to read before bed. And The ones that I'll flip through and I'll find the ones, and I feel like he's speaking to me right now.
And we just want to be instruments of his love, and we can't do it without each one of you. And this is the story of New Life Evangelistic Center for 50 years. I ask you to continue to keep New Life in your prayers as we continue to look to Jesus. You heard how you were an answer to the prayers of a homeless woman and a little boy by the name of Noah. And I ask all of you to just continue to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, and get your family, friends, your church involved, and share those gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can give online at NLECSTL.org. What a blessing you are in the lives of so many people. Again, I want to go back to Audrey and share with you an interview that I did earlier this week.
Audrey, we're here with you and the children. As we see, it's even hard to find a place to sleep outside at night. Were you worried before you came to New Life Evangelistic Center, safe houses, that'd be your situation?
Yeah. For the most part, before I even came to New Life, before I even gave my kids to their daddy, we were on a Metrolink. We would sleep on a Metrolink, or we'll be outside on the Metrolink at a bus stop sleeping because we had nowhere to go. And I figured it was the safest way for all of us to be together.
So you were sleeping out there. I don't know if these two remember that. That's been quite a few years back. Remember when you were outside sleeping on the Metrolink with Mama? You were just pretty young then, weren't you? Can you imagine that? But I did have a mother come in here that had a son about the age of this young man that had been sleeping in a tent out there recently, and they had everything they owned in a little wagon that they brought in. I mean, it's really hard out there right this
it
time.
It is. It really is hard because as women, we're trying to protect our children and make sure that they have somewhere to sleep and, you know, have food over their head. It's tough and it's hard. Like, we trying to make it. I know I'm trying to make it. I'm trying to make sure that my kids don't get taken. I'm trying to make sure that, you know, I give all my kids the right attention that they need, make sure they have clothes and food. And it's hard. Even with working, it's still hard because you don't make a whole lot. And without making a whole lot, you can't provide a whole lot for your children or yourself.
And Audrey, we've been working with her for quite a few years, came to us in the safe house. Now she's at a facility New Life has that she's paying partial rent. And even when she's got a job, just doesn't make enough to go the full route at this time. And then Section 8 has such a long waiting list.
Right. And then everything going up, food going up, gas going up, you know, the cost of living just going up. And it's just hard to make it. When you got a job, you think that you have a good paying job, and it's still not enough.
And there's so many that are out there, and a lot of them are starting to live outside, and yet the state passes its law, HB 1606, where they can actually lock them up. They're sleeping on state property. City did that in the month of May. People are hurting out there at this particular time. There's a lot of need. And New Life Evangelistic Center is working to be there. I met Julia the other day when I was out under this overpass. She's 5 months pregnant. Her family threw her out years ago when she was pregnant with her first child, and it's been really hard ever since. And we have others that have just come to us that are homeless. Melissa's just joined us at this time. She got a little baby. We have Shauna. She's got two children. A lot of mothers and children, they're coming to our safe houses. And then there's still so many that live outside. That's why our teams go out every day. My grandson, Chris Aaron, just left here a few minutes ago to catch up with the team, going out to the highways and byways. Pastor Ray does that on a daily basis. Your prayers are urgently needed. There's many, many people that need help and prayer at this time.
I'm back with Alyssa right now. And Alyssa, you were telling us earlier that in a moment of actual despair, you didn't know what else to do, where to go. You call out to God. You prayed to God. I guess you were afraid that DFS might try to take Noah and place him in another home or something?
Yes, yeah. After my other children had to be placed in the system and in other homes, it was very, very important for me that Noah stayed with me. Definitely, he's been my rock and my motivation for trying harder and working as hard as I do. So it was very important that I try to keep him with me, and not have to go through that again, while I'm battling, hopefully being reunited with my other children as quickly as possible.
In order to do that, again, you need a stable environment.
Mm-hmm.
She's in one of our safe houses right now. Each one of you that are praying and supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center, God was working through to answer her prayers after she called out to the Lord. He opened a door, and I thank God for each one of you. What a blessing you are as you partner with the New Life Evangelistic Center. And we have some really wonderful partners that have been with us now. It's been 50 years, and we're going to be celebrating this on September the 16th. And I want to encourage all of you, if you have not received your tickets, we provide those tickets to caring people like you. And it's going to be at the Royal Orleans. So we're going to be gathering there. I mean, it's going to be, there'll be a video presentation. Chris Aaron will bring you the latest in Ukraine. We want to bring this sister out where you can meet her personally and others of you. So plan to come and join us. And that's going to be the Royal Orleans restaurant. But you need to make reservations to do that. In order to do that, you need to call us at 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020. We ask you to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. You can also go online and learn more about the New Life Evangelistic Center and 50 years of reaching out through the love of Jesus for women and children. Well, it looks like we put Noah to sleep.
It is nap time.
Oh, he's about ready to go to sleep. And I hope the rest of you hadn't gone to sleep on it yet, because you got to get involved. We need you to wake up and let the light and love of Christ flow through you. It's no accident that you tuned in. It's no accident that you had an opportunity just to meet a few of the women and children that we have an opportunity to let the love of Christ flow in their life, be an answer to their prayers as you get directly involved. So please pray and care and share at this time and share that much needed gift with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can give online at NLECSDL.org. And again, having a little one like this and being homeless, just trying to find a place that he can sleep at.
Yeah, it's been a road, but I'm hopefully that road is going to be turning into better things very soon.
And now you're home at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and we praise God for that. And it looks like he's contented too. He's kind of went to sleep there with you right now. And it's just such a blessing to see the little children coming and to Jesus like this, and their mothers, because of each one of you wonderful, wonderful people. What a blessing you are. I ask you to continue to partner with us, and I really ask you to pray for us now at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Please pray. We do need a $200,000 miracle. That seems like overwhelming, but 1,000 people sharing $200 each, well, that need could be met. God is a miracle-working God, and there's many people in this community that could directly involve. So whatever you can share, please let the light and love of Christ flow through you. Remember the words of Jesus when he said, as oft as you've done it to the least of these, he said, even so you've done it unto me. So let's let his light and love flow. Please keep us in prayer at the New Life Evangelistic Center and share that much needed gift now. NLECSTL.org or P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166.